Hello, I'm Chris Menard. The other day I did a pivot table and I grouped text for you. This is the pivot table we ended up creating. I'm on it right now. So I took the car brands that were in Japan and put Japan there. America cars are in Americas and the others are there. So I was thinking about this after I made this video, and the question I have is, if you didn't want to do this with a pivot table, you could have used your source data and done a lookup. You could either have done a VLOOKUP or an XLOOKUP. I'm going to do this right now with an XLOOKUP. So I've already clicked over into the worksheet that contains my table. I did a Control T to make this. I know I've got a table because it says table design. I've got over in column B the car brands, but what I don't have in my source data, and this is why I just grouped in a pivot table the other day, is the country where those car brands are from. So I've thrown in this sheet called cars and countries. Column B has got the country. Column C has got the car brand. I put them all in here. I just went and pulled this from the web, by the way. So here we go with an XLOOKUP. And in case you're wondering, Chris, why are you doing an XLOOKUP instead of a VLOOKUP? A VLOOKUP will only look to the right. So I need to find this car brand GMC as an example. Go to this worksheet, find GMC here, which is right here in row 25, and then pull in America. An XLOOKUP will look left and right. A VLOOKUP will only look to the right. So that's why I've got to use the XLOOKUP, or I could have to rearrange the data, which I don't want to do. So here we go. Right now, and by the way, if you don't know how to use XLOOKUP and why I love it so much, check out my video up at the top and I'll put it down below too on XLOOKUP. Another cool advantage of having a table is when I come over here into cell G1, I'm going to just type in country. The table continues on. I don't have to go and resize the table. Here comes your XLOOKUP equals XLOOKUP. I want to find out GMC, what country it's in, comma, argument number two for XLOOKUP. Where do you want to go look? I'm going to go to the cars and country worksheet. I'm just going to simply highlight C2 down to C64. I'm up in the formula bar. So that is what I'm going to go look up. What's also cool about the XLOOKUP compared to VLOOKUP, now that I'm in here, is I don't have to go and select the whole range. I just did C2 to C64. Now in bold, it says, okay, if I find GMC in C2 to C64, what is it you want me to return? That's why it says return array. I'm going to just keep on typing. That's going to be B2. I told him I'm just highlight it with the mouse since I'm here. B2 to B64. I could have used the keyboard to select this. That's okay. I do comma. What if one of the car brands are not found on this worksheet right here? Again, you can't do this with VLOOKUP. I'm going to put brand not found, comma. And then here you go. This is what's also cool about an XLOOKUP. Can you tell that I love XLOOKUP? The default is an exact match, so I don't need to type in the zero, but I'm going to type it in anyway. We are done with one exception. I do need to use a little bit of absolute cell reference. B2 to B64 needs to be absolute. C2 to C64 needs to be absolute. Perfect. There you go. Y'all know this about tables, or maybe you don't. I started typing XLOOKUP in cell G2 because it's a table. It is called a calculated column. That is the term, calculated column. When I press enter, it automatically fills down. Watch this. Done. I don't have to go and click on G2 and get my mouse and do an autofill and all that. The calculated column will automatically autofill down. Also, this is just me right here. I would want to test this. If you recall, I want to make sure every car brand has a country. Let's turn on our filters real quick. Control Shift L is the keyboard shortcut. You can also go to data and turn on your filters here. I said, if something's not found, put in brand not found. And look, I don't see brand not found. Let's test this real quick. Back over here to cars and countries. It was, let me go and sort this. GM, I'm making this up. I'm going to delete that. Bye-bye. Back over here on my data. Brand not found. So I would do a filter, brand not found, and then go and fix these. Notice they're all GM. Let me go. I'm just going to undo to get it back, by the way. Good. And now, by the way, so now I've got to go and make the pivot table since I said, okay, I made this pivot table the other day without XLOOKUP. So now let me do it with the data that actually has it. So here comes the pivot table again. Insert pivot table. We only need three fields, by the way. I'm going to hit OK. I need to do a refresh real quick. How about that? Refresh. There we go. We want country, we want brand, and we want invoice amount. By the way, that was a great tip that I didn't mention. If you ever create a pivot table and all of a sudden you're like, oh, I think I'm missing some fields from my data, just right click and refresh and it'll pull everything in because country was not showing up. So here's the pivot table here. Quickly format the numbers. Not my favorite way to format, but it works for this example. 10,274, 10,274. So there's another way to handle that right there. It is a matter of preference. Both methods are great. I think I'm done. Hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to ring the bell, subscribe. Any comments or questions, put them down below. A lot of my pivot table videos are down below. Have a great day.